chances. You know, if he had been able to reset and maybe grab his BT, have his calling up, might have had a chance different when the Ring of Fire was there.
Yep, definitely agree. It's what happened, though. We are having the next round up pretty soon. Caps versus Chippies. That's going to be exciting. Caps, defending champion, defending world finalist. Mm-hmm. Absolutely excellent player. Going to be excited to see him go through. Chippies, to my understanding, Fly Academy new mid laner. That'll be exciting.
Yeah, and Pabu was talking about how he thinks, you know, if he can get a pretty good matchup, if he can get a good matchup, you know, he thinks he has a pretty good chance.
Ooh.
And this is interesting. So this is actually going to be Poppy versus Heimerdinger, and that is Cleanse. I don't know how useful Cleanse really is.
The wall slam?
But I mean, you could just not stand by the wall.
But can you, though?
Well, maybe not. Maybe that's why he's taking it. But it is pretty interesting setup here. Surprised to see Cleanse barrier. It is going to be Conqueror as well for the Heimerdinger.
I like it.
Okay.
So, because this is the really OP range champion Conqueror patch, right? We're on 923. The stack duration is very long. When spells hit, you still get two stacks. Heimer turrets count as spells, so it's very easy to get those stacks. Yeah, your auto-blink count is 11, who cares? So you're basically stacking Conqueror as fast as a melee champion would. Look, he's already stacked Conqueror.
Yeah.
And he's gonna lifesteal his damage.
My concern is that I think Poppy, what you're gonna actually try to do on a pick like this, is just wait until the Ring of Fire and ult the person out of the ring.
Yeah.
And at that point, Cleanse doesn't really help you, right? I think that having Flash when you are playing against a knockback champion like Poppy, like Tristana, Lee Sin, you know, Gragas, these sorts of champions to be able to outplay that is pretty important. Don't know that it'll end up mattering, but Chippies, you know, you're going to be looking for Grasp for Ass, throw the Buckler in every time you have Grasp active and just kind of try to poke away at Caps. Caps could perhaps, you know, go towards Azonias and try to actually immune the knockback ult if it comes to that sort of play, but we'll see how much he can pressure.
Well, right now, early turret damage is going to get the first plate. A little bit of money going into the pockets right there.
Yeah.
To find that poke, right? Lands it. The turrets go for the shot. That's Conqueror stacks. That's AP. That's damage.
Yeah, I mean, Chippies is struggling here a bit. You're not even really feeling comfortable to try to go for that Buckler of Harass. Missing almost all of the farm. So it is going to be pretty tough for him. You have to make sure you get the cannon. The cannon is just so ridiculously important on this map. You know, almost 200 gold from that.
Woo!
Oh, he's just getting smoked.
He gets into the heal range at the very least and finally gets a grasp off and gets some damage back, but...
That is a brutal setup, though. Cap just has his Ring of Turret, so if you ever step forward for a range minion and you get grenaded, you'll just die. And honestly, I think Chippy's just going to have to bite the bullet and recall, because if you try to stay out here longer, it's just going to get worse and worse for you.
Oh! Yeah, if that E landed, that was almost a kill.
Yeah, very, very close. So Cap's going to be able to shove this in, push in this wave, recall. Very likely Chippies will come back, but already two plates down off the turret, and Cap's pressuring for more.
This feels like one of the first turret wins we're going to play in the game.
He's going to all turret, wow.
And he's going to recall off it. It's going to be plate number three most likely. Like, he'll still be in range for the gold because the recall won't finish quite in time. Ooh. Oh, he's going to miss the gold because the recall, but that's honestly worth it to save the time.
Is the plate even going to die?
Maybe it won't.
It's oh my god. Okay.
I think it just dropped.
I think it's dead.
Yeah, it dropped at 950.
Okay, so it is a stopwatch. Okay, that's really smart. I mean, I just think that stopwatch gives you so much playmaking ability, you know, and
the
ability to actually cancel out a lot of this stuff. Yeah, you can stopwatch a potential Poppy ult if he's trying to reject you out of the zone. If Poppy looks for a hardcore all-in, you can drop all turret and stopwatch.
Yep.
So Caps sitting in a great position.
Whew.
You know, already gotten so much damage down in that turret, and Chippies, I think, is up against it. This is looking pretty one-sided.
He's going towards Adaptive Helm, and he'll be able to finish that before the Ring of Fire, so he can tank some of this eventually.
Yeah.
Like the build will eventually come in. The problem is, of course, he's obviously very far down in gold, and it also looks like this game is paced to actually go to turret destruction, which means Chippies will probably have to be forced to find an all-in earlier. He'll probably die by doing so, but this game likely ends with the turret dropping before the Ring of Fire.
I mean, Poppy just doesn't have good ways of actually dealing with the individual turrets, right? If you're playing some other champions, and Caps actually did get the turret blade.
Yeah, it hadn't dropped. But this is decent damage. Like, you can see the damage can exist.
Yeah.
It's close-ish, and he gets, you know, that's finally some buckler damage, but
picture the world in which...
Gets the shield. Wait, that's the turret! Okay.
Picture the world in which you're engaging into the three set of turrets in the middle of the Ring of Fire. Right?
Yep.
It's hard to see how he wins that.
Totally.
Unless maybe theoretically you can ult the turrets away and then win an all-in or something? I don't know.
Yeah, you line up through the turret goes away, so does Heimer. Or yeah, at least you like knock the ult turret out. Even if you even buy if, more time.
Yeah, I mean, even if Cap stopwatches your ult, if you can knock away the turrets, which I know you can do.
Yeah, it's better than nothing.
Maybe there's a possibility, but Chippy's missing the cannon there.
Ouch.
He's going to be so far down on gold, and he's got a recall. Ult is up for Cap, so there's potential he could actually just kill the turret.
Okay, well, he's going to buy some time there, but Cap's going to walk right back in. He could have taken that as a reset, but he's like, no. I'm going for plate number four.
He's going to alter it.
Yep. And he waited until something else took aggro, put another one of his turrets in front. So I believe a mini turret's taking aggro. Yeah, like he played this, like, even the mechanics of placing the turrets down is correct, right? The ult turret was in the back to not take damage so it could do maximum damage. That's down to last plate. It's down to 370 health or something like that. Like, this is so close to dead. One final reset and he wins on turret.
Yeah, it is really close. Oh, we'll see if Chippies can actually stop.
He has to try to find the all-in. I think it's correct. Of course, that stun was perfect. And, like, a flash E maybe hits the wall and maybe there's some kind of follow-up damage, but this turret's almost gone. It's at 243.
So I will say, I think we're actually going to get to Ring of Fire because I think you could maybe kind of trade aggressively a little bit to try to survive. The problem is, even if he survives the Ring of Fire, if you're having to trade your HP out for that and then you're too low for the actual spawning of it, then you're not going to be able to win the all-in in there.
Yep.
So Caps kind of is holding all the cards. You know, this is reminding me a little bit of when we saw the CS win conditions where people would be forced into really bad all-ins that don't look close.
Yeah.
I could see that happening to Chippies here. But he did get the recall off.
Yep.
He has adaptive. He has an additional null. Obviously, the itemization a lot stronger here for Caps, though.
This is the moment, basically. Like, this is the wave. Because Caps will just ult-Q the turret, and it just ends the game.
But
so
he doesn't have ult yet. So that's why I think it's going to go to the Ring of Fire.
And Chippies pulls the wave over, tries to jump forward. He can go for a point blank ult a little bit once it comes back up. And here comes the fight. Decent damage. Shield comes in. And hey, you know, Death of Helm Bill has a little bit of work, but now the wave clear is here. Or the wave itself is here, really.
Yeah. This is rough. Chippies is... Like, you can't base now because you lose your turret.
Yeah.
And if you don't base, you're going to lose the all-in.
Big damage. So the ring is going to spawn in 30. So you're right, that might happen. Decent damage here. And Chippies is going to stay alive, gets the buckler from a last hit. That was good, like, awareness. So switch over, say, I see a cast minion, knock that down, get some HP, but here comes the wave clear. Cap's a bit low on mana, but he's got enough with double Thorns. And here comes the wave. This is the wave that would end the game.
Yeah, you could even just ult turret right now.
Flash E.
Or he's just going for
he's
it.
Trying to hit the turret and not pull aggro. He cannot auto attack. That's going to be one hit. That's the game. Nicely done, Caps.
Yeah, he played that out really intelligently. Never even gave Chippies an opportunity to actually, you know, go for that ultimate cheese at the end to knock him out into the ring. And this is the first turret win I have seen. We had an entire internal tournament, right? Never saw the turret go down. They did lower.
How many Heimer players were there, though?
I don't know.
Okay.
But, you know, they did lower the turret health.
Yeah.
So that is down to try to compensate for some of the turtle league strategies.
Yep.
Cap's very confident for this. Chippy's looking for the flash stun, but not too close. Cap still had the ult, still had the barrier and cleanse.
Yeah.
And that was just really well played. Cap's kind of just controlled his start to finish.
I do think it's interesting. I'm curious your thoughts on this as well, to have a discussion. Right. Cap's destroyed this match, right? He was absurdly far ahead every step of the way. And it still took until almost Ring of Fire to finish the turret off.
Yeah.
Like, it was extended that long and probably the most lopsided Siege versus Defense matchup. And so that's the taste. Like, that is what this is going to look like. It's going to be the full 6.5 minutes of slowly wearing it down until it's finally time to go. And then even then, Adaptive Hell was still done, right? Even on the back foot, where Chippies could not do anything the entire time, he got to one completed item.
Yeah. Yeah, you pretty much always do, unless you're getting no cannons, because as you get progressively further behind, you get more and more gold from the cannons. So, you know, it is really trying to give you some sort of chance. Like, it's almost impossible to not get one item, you know, as long as you're surviving that long. So it is pretty rough, but we are seeing Tristana versus Tristana, actually. I think Uzi is going to have a